Over the period of time, SpaceX has upgraded their Starship, on top of major design changes made to Starship and Super Heavy booster. Over the last year, as SpaceX continues to refine the rocket, the company also developed a substantially different version of Starship and its Raptor engine. Starship aiming to perform its first orbital launch later this month, SpaceX are once again attempting to create history. But in order for this first test flight to be a success, SpaceX has to be sure that the 33 Raptor engines on the bottom of Super Heavy will fire without any significant problems. Join us as we bring you Elon Musk and SpaceX makes major improvement on Starship and Super Heavy before first orbital launch later this year. SpaceX continues to work around the clock to prepare its latest Starship and Super Heavy booster prototypes for another week of testing, likely focused on firing up the Raptor engines installed on each vehicle. Known as Booster 7 and Ship 24, SpaceX has been slowly testing both prototypes for approximately 4 months, beginning in April and May, respectively. Only in early August did the company cautiously begin attempting to ignite their Raptor engines as part of a process known as static fire testing. By far the most difficult and important part of qualifying both vehicles for flight. Thanks to progress made in 2021, SpaceX already has significant experience testing an earlier orbital-class Starship prototype on the ground. But the process of testing Ship 24 is still fresh and unfamiliar for a number of reasons. For Booster 7, the challenges are even greater. On top of major design changes made to Starship and Super Heavy, over the last year as SpaceX continues to refine the rocket. The company also developed a substantially different version of its Raptor engine. Compared to Raptor V1, Raptor V2 almost looks like a new engine and can produce around 25% more thrust than Raptor engine, likely 230 tons versus 185 tons. SpaceX has also tweaked how the engine operates, particularly around startup and shutdown. Further weakening the value of past experience, testing Raptor V1 and V1.5 engines on Ship 20 and Boosters 3 and 4. In other words, with Ship 24 and Booster 7 engine testing, it's possible that SpaceX is effectively starting from scratch. Many aspects of testing, propellant conditioning, thermal characteristics, tanking, detanking, certain test stands, are likely mostly unchanged, but almost every aspect of a rocket is affected by its engines. Before SpaceX began testing Raptor V2 engines on Starship and booster prototypes, it wasn't clear if the changes between V1.5 and V2 would invalidate a lot of prior testing. After the start of Booster 7 and Ship 24 static fire testing, it's now clear that a lot of that earlier work has to be redone. It's also clear that despite some of the simplifications in Raptor V2 design, operating the engine on Starship and Super Heavy is much harder get right. Since mid-July, SpaceX has completed around 15 to 20 spin prime tests between Ship 24 and Booster 7. More of that kind of test than any other prototype in the history of Starbase has performed. Spin prime tests flow high-pressure gas through Raptor's pumps to spin them up without igniting anything. It's unclear why so many of those tests are being done, what SpaceX is gaining from it, or why the company appears to have completely stopped conducting preburner tests. A more lifelike spin prime with partial combustion. Regardless, 8 weeks after the start of engine testing, Booster 7 has only performed 3 static fires, 2 with one engine. One with a max of 3 or 4 engines, and Ship 24 has only completed 1 static fire with 2 engines. Before either vehicle can be considered ready for flight, a day that could easily never come, each will likely need to conduct multiple successful static fires, with all of their Raptor engines, 6 on S24 and 33 on V7. If the pace of Booster 7 testing doesn't change, the vehicle could be months away from a full 33-engine static fire attempt. Perhaps the single most important and uncertain test, standing between SpaceX and Starship's first orbital launch attempt. Ship 24's path to flight readiness should be simpler, but it appears to be struggling almost as much. According to CEO Elon Musk, an intense effort is underway to ensure that Super Heavy B7's Raptor engines are well contained during anomalies. So that one engine violently failing won't damage or destroy the booster, other engines, or the launch pad. That could certainly complicate the process of testing Booster 7, and it's likely that SpaceX is taking some of the same actions to protect Ship 24. So when will we see the first full-fledged static fires in Super Heavy? The current Super Heavy B7 is back to the launch site with a factory upgrade. SpaceX is busy with Super Heavy and Starship 24 testing. So far, SpaceX has only performed a few pressure tests on Booster 7 and 3-engine static fire test, their most complete Super Heavy booster. These tests usually involve filling the booster's tanks with cryogenic liquid, to simulate the temperatures and pressures it will experience during a flight. But the most realistic test that needs to be completed, before Booster 7 ever lifts off, will be a complete static fire, using all 33 of its engines. So let me tell you that September is going to be even more exciting, as the full testing of 33 Raptors is guaranteed to be very exciting. When will Starship fly? The first orbital test flight of SpaceX's Starship vehicle won't get off the ground in August. SpaceX is targeting a six-month window that opens on September 1 for the highly anticipated mission. According to a radio spectrum license application, opens in new tab that the company filed with the U.S. Federal Communications Commission. But this approval is not the final regulatory hurdle that Starship must clear on the way to the launch pad. SpaceX apparently still hasn't received a launch license for the Starship orbital test flight, which will lift off from the company's Starbase facility in South Texas. Launch licenses are the purview of the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration, which recently wrapped up a lengthy environmental assessment of Starship activities at the site. Starship consists of a giant first-stage booster called Super Heavy, and a 165-foot-tall 50-meters upper-stage spacecraft known as Starship. Both elements are designed to be fully reusable, and both will be powered by SpaceX's next-generation Raptor engines, 33 for Super Heavy and 6 for Starship. The duo that will fly the coming orbital mission are Booster 7 and Ship 24. So a lot of work remains before SpaceX clears the duo for an orbital flight, meaning it was never likely that the mission would lift off in September, even if all the paperwork were already in order. After SpaceX, NASA is definitely the one most looking forward to this flight. The agency has already made a bet on Starship, with a selection as the human landing system for Artemis, the largest cutting-edge vehicle now on the critical path to land humans on the moon, NASA's most ambitious human spaceflight program in half a century. As a result, NASA's watching every step of the development of SpaceX Starship next. It can't be denied that this orbital flight has implications for the entire space industry and our planet. This flight will open the door to orbital tourist flights, which could render the aircraft industry obsolete. It's also one of the goals of SpaceX. The coming orbital test flight is a critical step along that path. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, to make sure you can subscribe. If you have any crazy idea what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we will see if we can get the, and thanks again for watching and goodbye.